Welcome dear students to the third lecture in mechanical measurement in unit 1 measuring instruments. We will start this session with a definition and basic concepts that are required in measuring instruments. So the first definition is reliability of an instrument. So what is the meaning of reliability of an instrument? The term reliability indicates the closeness with which the scale of an instrument may be read. So jitna close se main instrument ko read sakta hu, that is nothing but reliability of an instrument. So I'll give you an example for it. An instrument with 30 centimeter would have a higher reliability than an instrument with 15 centimeter scale. मतलब मेरे पास एक स्केल है, उसका 30 सेंटीमीटर का स्केल है और दूसरा स्केल मेरे पास 15 सेंटीमीटर का है. सो 30 सेंटीमीटर का स्केल मुझे मैं 20 सेंटीमीटर, 22 सेंटीमीटर, 20 सेंटीमीटर आई कैन रीड दैट इन दिस इंस्ट्रूमेंट. दैट इज नोन एज रिलायबिलिटी ऑफ एन इंस्ट्रूमेंट. सो नेक्स्ट डेफिनेशन, लीस्ट काउंट. सो व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ लीस्ट काउंट? It is the smallest difference between two indication that can be detected on the instrument scale. In other words, it is the smallest division I can measure on a given instrument. To take for example the common scale, whatever we use in day-to-day life, of 15 centimeter ka scale jo kuch hum log bol rahe, smallest reading I can measure is 1 mm. That is what is the least count, or 0.1 centimeter is the least count. If you take any other device, you take vernier scale, you can take micrometer. So depending on that vernier scale or micrometer, depending on the indentations or the markings on that scale, I can find out the least reading I can measure on that instrument. That is known as least count. The third one, range. So what is the meaning of range? It represents the highest possible value that can be measured by an instrument, or it is a difference between the largest and the smallest results of the measurement. So if I got a scale of 30 centimeters, so maximum I can measure is 30 centimeters. That is from 0 to 30 centimeters. That is what is range. Next, sensitivity. So what is the meaning of sensitivity? The sensitivity of an instrument is the ratio of the linear measurement of the pointer on the instrument to the change in the measured variable causing this motion. So if there is change in the measured variable, whatever measured variable I am measuring it, if it is not been indicated on the pointer in the linear scale, then it is not sensitive. For the smallest of the reading, if it is indicating on the linear measurement of the scale, then it is sensitive. So we call it as a sensitivity. Example, a 1 millivolt recorder might have a 10 centimeter scale length. Its sensitivity would be 10 centimeters per millivolt, assuming that the measurement was linear all across the scale. So if it is linear across the scale, then I can measure its sensitivity. The static sensitivity of an instrument can be defined as slope of the calibration curve as shown in the figure. If I take this figure and show you the curve, so now you can take this, you have an output. Output is given to us, and we have the input. In for a given input, we have an output, and then what I will do is I will plot this curve. So I am plotting this curve. So when I plot this curve, then what I do? I find out its sensitivity, that is change in x-axis and change in y-axis. So the difference in this x-axis reading and the difference in y-axis reading will give me what is known as sensitivity. So it determines me what is known as sensitivity. So in other words, I can say that it is change in output signal divided by change in input signal. So what is the change in input signal? X2 minus X1 along X axis and Y2 minus Y1 along Y axis. That is, Y axis is change in output and X2 minus X1 is change in input. That gives me what is known as sensitivity. The sensitivity of an instrument should be high. So I should have a very high sensitivity, and the instrument should not have a range greatly exceeding the value to be measured. So the range, whatever is there, should not be higher than the value should not be more than the range which I am going to measure. The next term comes is known as hysteresis. An instrument is said to exist hysteresis when there is a difference in reading depending on whether the value of the measured quantity is approached from higher value or from a lower value, as shown in figure. So with the figure I'll explain you what is the meaning of this hysteresis. So now what I'm doing, I'm starting from this zero now. So I have a scale, I'll start from this zero, I will go to the maximum value. So from here I'm reaching the maximum value, and then what I do, I will reduce this value. As I'm plotting it on the scale, I'll reduce this value, go to the minimum value, and then again increase the value. So when I do this, right, it is not going to trace the same path again. So the path traced when it is decreasing and the path traced when I am increasing are not same. There is a difference in the values. There is difference in these values. This difference in the values gives me what is known as hysteresis. You can see here the difference from this x-axis value to the descending value when it is at zero. When x is zero, y has some value. That gives me what is known as output hysteresis. When the output y-axis is zero, it has some input here. It has some input, this input value. So this difference, whatever I am finding out, gives me what is known as maximum input hysteresis. Similarly, you are going to have a value when this x is zero, y has some value here. So this gives me what is known as maximum output hysteresis. Hysteresis arises because of mechanical friction, magnetic effects, elastic deformation, or thermal effects. So due to these effects, there is hysteresis. Hysteresis means there is change in the values. It is not going to have the same value when I am going in the forward direction and then coming back in the backward direction, and from backward to again forward direction. It is not going to have the same path traced, or the graph is not going to remain the same. A system free from hysteresis will produce the same readings irrespective of whether the reading has been achieved by increasing from a lower value or decreasing from a higher value. Either I am increasing from lower value or increasing from higher value. So if I am increasing from lower value, I am not going to get the same direction, or if I am decreasing from the higher value, the path traced is not the same. Then the next is known as true value or actual value. It is the actual magnitude of the input signal. So whatever is this actual value is known as true value. The evaluation of this quantity may be appreciated but never truly determined. So you are not determining it truly. The true value may be defined as the average of an infinite number of measured values. So if I take the average of the infinite values, then I'll get what is known as true value. When the average deviation due to various contributing factors tend to zero. So this is very, very important for me. That is, this average, then the next term is known as indicated value. The magnitude of the input signal indicated by a measuring instrument is known as indicated value. So whatever instrument is going to give me the value, right, so is known as indicated value. Then corrections. So what is the meaning of corrections? It is the revision applied to the indicated value which improves the witness of the result. So when it is improving the worthiness of the result, then we call it as correction. So what is this correction known as? Such revision may be in the form of either an additive factor or a multiplier or both. So you are adding some factor to some value, or you are dividing some by some factor. So that is known as correction. So we write the equation now, C equal to VA minus VI, that is true value minus indicated value. That C is known as correction. This C is called as what? Correction. So VA is the true value, VI is the indicated value. The difference between that is known as correction. Then the next term that comes is known as result. So it is obtained by making all known corrections to the indicated value. So whatever is that indicated value, for that whatever corrections have to be done. So we are doing that corrections to this input value VI, and then we are finding out the result. So where A and B, this A and B are known as multiplying or additive corrections. So VI equal to A VI plus B. So whatever are these constants, you are adding to that VI to get the result. Then discrepancy. So what is the meaning of discrepancy? The difference between two indicated values or results determined from a supposedly fixed true values. So if I have a true value, for that true value, if I am getting two indicated values, the difference between those two indicated values gives me what is known as discrepancy. Then error. The difference between the true value and the result is known as error. That is, error equal to VR minus VA. The accuracy of an instrument is measured in terms of its error. If the error of the instrument is less, error of the instrument is minimum, then it has more accuracy. If I take, for example, a clock, if I use this clock for 1 hour, then from 1 hour to 2 hours, then for 1 day, 2 days, 3 days, suppose a clock gives me, after 10 days there is increase in the time, increases by 1 minute, 1 minute it goes ahead. There is one more clock, after 1 day it goes ahead by 10 minutes. So error is more, its accuracy is less. Got the meaning of error and accuracy? Next, accuracy. The accuracy of an instrument indicates the deviation of the resulting from a known input. So from that known input, if I am deviating, right, it gives me what is known as accuracy. So how much it is nearer to that value. In other words, accuracy is the closeness with which the readings of an instrument approaches the true values of the quantities measured. So whether it is achieving that true value or no, we need to find out. If it is not achieving the true value, how much close to that true value it is, that gives me what is known as accuracy. Accuracy may be expressed in percentage based on either actual scale readings or full scale readings. So if I have got actual scale readings, I can write it according to actual scale readings, or if I have got a full scale readings, I can write according to full scale readings. So I can write it as percentage accuracy is equal to VR minus VA divided by VA into 100, where VR is known as maximum or minimum result value and VA is known as actual value. And if you are writing in terms of full scale value, you can write it as percentage accuracy equal to VR minus VA divided by VFS into 100, where VFS is full scale reading. You can see this from the equation here. The first equation is pertaining to actual scale. The second equation is pertaining to full scale, that is VR minus VA divided by VFS into 100. Then precision. This is also one of the important terms required for an instrument. The precision of an instrument indicates its ability to reproduce a certain reading with a given accuracy. It should be able to reproduce that reading every time when I am using that instrument. It should not deviate from the reading. If I take the reading now, 1 month after, or even 1 year after, or even 10 years after, it should give me the same reading for a given same input. That is very, very important. That is what is nothing but precision. It is the degree of agreement between repeated results. How much nearer to date it is? The repeated results should have the same value. If it is changing, then it is, the precision is low. The precision refers to the repeatability of measuring process. That is, the closeness with which the measurement of the same physical quantity agree with one another. So it should have the same value every time when I am measuring it. If it changes, then there is, the precision is not there for that instrument, or the precision does not exist for that instrument. Example, if I take an example to differentiate between precision and accuracy, consider the measurement of a known voltage of 100 volts with a certain meter. 5 readings are taken. So if I have taken 5 readings and the indicated values are 104, 103, 105, 103 and 105 volts respectively. From these values, the accuracy of an instrument is, so I can find out the accuracy. What is the maximum value I have? It is 105 minus. What is the actual value? I need to get 100 divided by, again, actual value 100 into 100. So 105 minus 100 divided by 100 into 100. It is 5%. Then if I take a mean of these values, 104, 103, 105, 103 and 105 respectively. So if I add them and divide by 5, I'll get the mean as 104. So I'll get this mean as 104 and the accuracy is 5%. Then with this I can find out what is known as precision. While the precision is plus or minus 1%, since the maximum deviation from the mean readings of 104 volt is only 1 volts. So I am getting 5% variation. 5% is 100 plus 5 is 105. So what is the precision? It is plus or minus 1% is the precision, and that is deviation from the mean value. It may be noted that the instrument would be calibrated so that it would be used to dependently measure voltages within plus or minus 1 volt. So I can measure it within 1 or plus or minus 1 volt. From this it is clear that accuracy can be improved up, but not beyond the precision of the instrument by calibration. So I cannot go beyond its precision. I can only reach nearer to the precision. Accuracy can be reached nearer to the precision, but I cannot go beyond this precision. Then resolution or discrimination. Resolution is defined as the smallest increment of input signal that a measuring system is capable of displaying. So whatever is that smallest reading I can display on the instrument, that is known as resolution. Then the next is threshold. If the instrument input is increased very gradually from zero, there will be some minimum value below which no output change can be detected. This minimum value defines the threshold of the instrument. Now if I take this example, I have got a weighing balance where I am measuring the weight in kgs, 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg, In that way, I am measuring the weight. So if I have a weight of 1.05 kg also, it shows me only 1 kg. So that 0.05 kg, whatever I added, is not shown. So that is known as the minimum value I can measure. I can measure 1, I can measure 2, but I cannot measure 1.05. It shows me 1. If I try to measure 1.05, it shows me 1. So what is that threshold? It is 1. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is nothing but the threshold. Thus, resolution defines the smallest measurable input change, while threshold defines this smallest measurable input. So I can measure in terms of kg, 1 kg, 2 kg in that way, but I cannot measure that smallest value. But that smallest value can be determined where? In resolution. So it defines me what? The smallest measurable input. So I can measure 0.05 easily. That is usable. So that is the resolution of the instrument. Threshold is measured when the input is variable from 0, while resolution is measured when the input is varied from any arbitrary non-zero value. So I give you example for this. So I have taken 1, I have taken 2 kg, 3 kg. If I take, for example, 0 kg, if the weight is not there, it shows me 0. But if I take 1 kg, 2 kg, 3 kg, it is shown. But 1.05, it is not shown. So to see that value, resolution tells me that. That is, the resolution is measured when input is varied from any arbitrary non-zero value. So non-zero value here is 1. So I am increasing from 1 to 1.05. So that 0.05 is visible for that measured instrument if it is so sensitive. That gives me what is known as resolution.